always serving a fresh cup of daily inspiration, Dianna Hobbs.
Today's inspiration is to let you know there is a purpose for this valley. This season, you're walking through this low place that you find yourself in. That area that just won't come together has a purpose. And instead of focusing on the valley, focus on the one who walks through the valley of the shadow of death with you, and fear no evil, because not only is he there, but he is going to raise you up out of this valley and make you an example of his glory. Welcome to this, your Wednesday, August 1st, 2018 edition of your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast. My name is Dianna Hobbs, founder of Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, a 501c3 nonprofit organization that distributes free resources worldwide to help you grow in your faith and become everything God has destined you to be. I bring you warm greetings live from Empowering Everyday Women Ministry Studios right here in the city of Buffalo, New York. It is currently 74 degrees in the Queen City. It is a lovely day. I am just on a high reading all these praise reports that you send. The Daily Cup community is flourishing, and that is only by the power and grace of God. I am grateful. Every single podcast you hear is available for you as a free resource. Stream and download it on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher.com, Player.fm, YourDailyCupOfInspiration.com, on my YouTube channel under my name, Dianna Hobbs, DiannaHobbs. Click that red subscribe button, turn on your notifications, and every time a podcast is uploaded, you'll be among the first to know. Follow on social media, Twitter at Team Dianna Hobbs, Facebook at Dianna.Hobbs, and Instagram at I Am Dianna Hobbs. Let's dive into this Wednesday word, but first a prayer. God, our Father, we love you. We thank you for this day, for this set time you have ordained specifically to minister to and encourage the individual you sent to press play. God, because they have opened their heart, fill it to overflowing that they might move forward in faith, knowing that your purpose will prevail. In Jesus' name, amen. Daily Cup family, it was quite some time ago, but I remember I was working at a department store trying to make ends meet. My husband and I, we had small children and we got behind on the bills. He was working hard, and so I had to pick up some additional work at a local mall as a sales associate. And my manager over me, who was younger than me, said something that seemed so random, but it was very hurtful one day. And her exact words were, "I'd kill myself if I were married with kids and still working here." And she started laughing. She was fresh out of college, really smart, maybe around 21. She expressed that in her eyes, the fact that I was older than she was and working a minimum wage job to make ends meet for my family meant I was a loser. I cannot deny her words stung. So it took all the prayer and the word I had in me to uproot the seeds of inferiority she tried to plant in my mind. It baffled me that she would say these things. Although working as a sales associate wasn't my ideal, it's not what I imagined I'd be doing as a wife and mom with a college degree, it was what my situation called for at the moment. I was just grateful to have a job and to be able to contribute something at home. Nevertheless, Satan did all he could to stigmatize my position, to poke holes in my confidence. He echoed her words and told me, "You're too old to be this far behind in life." I firmly believed then, just as I do now, that my times and my seasons are in his hands, and whether I'm on the mountain or in the valley, there is a purpose for it. And I believe that the Lord allowed me to go through that experience because he knew one day he would launch me into ministry and I would encourage somebody else to know that the enemy has lied to you, and he has tried to make you feel like you're not enough, like you're too far behind, like this is all there is. He takes every occasion to kick you while you're down, but God has a purpose for your life. This is not the end for you. Whatever circumstance you find yourself in, it is not too late. Friend, even when I was scraping by week to week, selling bridal gifts and operating in a hostile work environment, God knew what he had placed in me. He was fully aware of how he would use my life to glorify His name. He has plans for you just the same. There's a purpose for this valley. I don't know exactly what you're facing or walking through or what kind of opposition you're dealing with, but God wants you to know it is not too late. You will rebound. A change is coming. You will be a reflection of His goodness, grace, and favor. Even when your advancement, your elevation, your breakthrough does not happen on your timetable or on society's timetable, God is still able. He isn't hung up on your age, your biological clock, your deadline for certain milestones or personal ultimatums. God doesn't do what is most convenient for our schedule, but what is most conducive to Him receiving glory. In John 11, when Mary and Martha sent word to Jesus that their brother Lazarus was sick, Jesus didn't rush to Bethany where He was. He did not hurry up and show up on the scene. Nope. Jesus said, "This sickness will not end in death. No, it is for God's glory, so that God's Son may be glorified through it." The Messiah didn't arrive until after Lazarus was placed in the tomb and family and friends were mourning His death. Jesus let the situation get to the point where nobody thought it could be helped or turned around. Always remember, everything is about God's glorification, so that others will believe that He is who He says He is. It never has been, nor ever will be, about us. The purpose in this valley is bigger than you. It's greater than your feelings or emotions. It has nothing to do with your comfort, but everything to do with how God's going to turn that thing around. In verse 39, when He told them to roll that stone away, Lazarus's sister Martha thought the Savior was going too far. She told Him the stench of the decomposing body would be too great. There was no way this was a good idea. But when the Son of God called Lazarus forth, no matter who didn't believe it, the one who was dead got up at Christ's command. After Jesus raised Lazarus, verse 45 says, "Therefore many of the Jews who had come to visit Mary and had seen what Jesus did believed in Him." They had to first become eyewitnesses before they could become faith witnesses. They needed to see what Jesus did in order to see who He was. Right now, you're dealing with some things and you don't know how God is going to turn them around. Well, I've got good news. He specializes in desperate situations. He lets you face the too high mountain and walk through the too low valley so you can see that He is too powerful for any obstacle to withstand. God is going to reveal His glory. That is the purpose for this valley. That is the purpose for this test. That is the purpose for the rough road you've been walking. That's the purpose for the tears that you have cried. That is the purpose for the pain that you have felt. That is the purpose for the storm you have had to endure for God to get glory. He's just setting the stage. God is going to breathe new life into your situation. Somebody listening to me right now has been going through a dry season. There seems to be no hope, no life, no possibility of resurrection or restoration. Oh, but the Lord sent Dianna Hobbs to tell you that He's breathing on that issue, that problem, that circumstance, that situation that has you down and seemingly unable to rise again. It's changing for the better. God is breathing on it. I know it may look impossible. Some things seem too far gone and too difficult for God to ever fix, restore, or renew. But is anything too hard for God? Nothing, no thing, and no one is beyond His power to heal, beyond His power to restore, beyond His power to set free, beyond His power to lift up. God is mighty. He is a strong deliverer. Not even death can hold Him down. So don't worry about what you're facing. God allowed it for His glorification. Don't get discouraged over the valley. There's a purpose for it. It is His glorification. God is doing a new thing. You're coming back from this. The purpose of this valley is for God to prove to you and everyone else who can observe your situation that He is sovereign, that He is able to exceed your wildest expectations. That's why I'm stirring the very popular scripture that I reinforce so often into your cup of inspiration today. And we discover that passage of scripture right in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20 in the New International Version, which says, "Now to Him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to His power that is at work within us." As you drink down the contents of your cup, keep on believing and looking with expectation for the day when the resurrection of your situation will take place. Don't worry whether 4 days, 4 weeks, 4 months, 4 years, or what feels like forever has passed. It will all work out. Now let's pray. God, God, I pray for this, my sister, this, my brother. Thank you for breathing the breath of life into their situation. I rejoice over the fact that you are turning around what looks impossible because you're sovereign. Today, despite the odds, help them to look forward with earnest expectations of the great things that you will do. They will rise again, and the purpose of this valley, which is your glorification, will be manifested for all to see. I praise you in advance, for nothing is too hard for you. We glorify you now together in Jesus' name. Amen.
Your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast has been brought to you by Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, where we help fuel your faith every day. For more information, log on to www.DiannaHobbs.com.